Thank you very much. I'm very pleased to be here and to represent Afghanistan, as you said. I'm leading actually a project which is financed by the government of Japan, and there is some progress that we are trying to make. Tomorrow I will have a presentation on the FMD vaccination, which is one important component. But what I wanted to focus in this presentation is on some of the well, why we are doing all this. It's Afghanistan is part of the West Eurasia regional roadmap, and the activities that we are supporting and implementing, the purpose is to bring the country into stage two of the PCP. I think it has already been mentioned, and you have maybe the possibility to see the country is currently qualified in stage one of the PCP. And so the purpose is to bring the country into stage two. And one important thing is that the activities which are currently implemented in Afghanistan, they go under this terminology that has been used quite frequently. I saw recently this public-private partnership. It's an important thing to understand a little bit. In Afghanistan, there has been a shift. So all the field activities, including vaccination, they are currently carried out by the private sector. So the public sector can actually engage the private sector into the implementation of field activities. And the public sector maintains the responsibility for monitoring and evaluating the correct implementation of these activities. As FAO, we are in the middle because we are supporting the public sector in carrying out this responsibility, and the private sector, we are supporting them for the implementation, for example, of vaccination, among other activities. So this is the framework that is currently present. The activities that now we are currently carrying out, as I said, the main scope is to bring the country into PCP stage two. And we have identified five major pillars through which implement, to which basically address and strengthen some of the issues that we may have in a country like Afghanistan. And those are basically strengthening the laboratory capacity at both laboratory and field level, improving the current surveillance system for FMD, but also for other diseases. Implementation of a targeted vaccination program, which I will present tomorrow more in detail, and improvement of the current legislation framework. This is quite a challenging issue, and I will explain maybe a little bit better more. And then promote a more intensive involvement of stakeholders on FMD control, which is also another rather important issue. I will go very briefly, but strengthening the diagnostic capacity, I think we have we are working together with the General Directorate of the Veterinary Service in Afghanistan, and one of the things is that the capacity in terms of diagnostic capacity at laboratory level, I think, is quite good. There has been previously also a project which was supported by the European Union, and the capacity is there. What we have done in order to continue the work which has been previously done by the other project is to establish one expert. Many of you know is Dr. Nazim Shirazi from Iran. He's currently working with us and is sitting together with the staff at the Central Veterinary Diagnostic and Research Laboratory and providing all type of assistance that they may need. The current support that FAO is giving is mainly on providing support in provision of diagnostic and laboratory reagents. FMD is, there are just some data here, from 1st of January up to 4th of October, the laboratory has received 190 tissue samples, and you can see that several of them are positive for type O, which is the dominant serotype currently present. But the laboratory has also capacity for NSP testing, SP testing for antibodies, and also ELISA for antigen detection. Strengthening the laboratory capacity at field level means refresh training for these veterinary field units, which we have supported this activity at the end of 2015. More than 1,000 field operators were trained on basically on FMD on PPR, and they were submitted a questionnaire at the end of the training whether they had seen a disease like FMD and PPR in their recent field activities, and the results of the questionnaire basically confirm what it has been observed through the laboratory data. I cannot go into details, but the surveillance system, which is also another part, and also here there is a sort of public-private partnership. The current surveillance system is based on approximately 340 contracted veterinary field units. These are private field operator. I call that field operator because not necessarily they are veterinarians. They can also be para-veterinarians. And they are supposed to report every month. They are basically the sentinels throughout the country of what is going on, and they are supposed to report at the central level occurrence of a list of a notifiable disease. I think the arrangement under which this is done is called the sanitary mandate contractual scheme, which I think is a good arrangement, but there are problems, I think, in the implementation phase. So it needs to be revised, and this is one of the activities that we are currently doing together with the General Directorate of the Veterinary Service. The main issue remains the response mechanism, especially for FMD. If you see FMD, what do you do? Basically, now nothing. There is no response mechanism in place. The other pillar was control and prevention, and what we are supporting now, which we hope it will would allow the country to move into PCP stage 2, is a target vaccination program covering the dairy sector. FAO has worked a lot in the recent past to establish a milk processing plant and establish also a cooperative dairy system that delivered the milk into this milk processing plant. There are 5 dairy unions established in the country. There are a certain number of cooperatives which are conferring the milk to this milk production plant, and a certain number of village-level cooperative systems. So this is the target for our vaccination program, and we will discuss it more in detail tomorrow. And where you see in blue is in orange, is the location of the 5 dairy unions established and registered within the Ministry of Agriculture and Irrigation and Livestock. Improvement of the current legislation framework, I mentioned before, it's rather challenging, and one of the reasons, at least this is my personal opinion, so nothing to do with FAO opinion or other, is Afghanistan recently joined officially as a member of the WTO, member of the World Trade Organization. Apparently, many people are happy about this. I'm not so happy. And the reason is because the legislation framework is still weak. And if the country is called to, because they have obligation now to fulfill the sanitary and phytosanitary agreement, but without the strong legislation framework, it's difficult to operationalize activities at the field level in order to fulfill the sanitary and phytosanitary agreement. So there is a lot of work now that needs to be done in order to improve the legislation framework. And it's not only related to FMD, it's also related to other things. So I see some vulnerability of the country in this regard, and I hope Afghanistan will not become the basket of trash that, you know, everybody can put it there, because they cannot say, yeah, no, but you know, you have to have in order to refuse a commodity, a good, you have to have a certain level of protection inside. But If you don't have a legislation framework, how can you claim that you are addressing your risk up to a certain level? So to me, this is a big challenge that we are trying to work on. The last one, promote a more intensive involvement of stakeholders. This means that what we are trying to do in promoting also the vaccination program is to have a more and more engagement of additional stakeholders, creating more cooperative at the village level, because it's not only related to FMD, it's also related to food safety. The milk which is produced by those producers which are engaged into the dairy union system, at least the milk that they produce enter into a food chain system in which the milk is pasteurized, at the end is a safe product for the consumers. Milk which is sold at the bazaar level may not have this type of quality. So we are trying to use, in a way, FMD to promote a more engagement of the stakeholders. So I conclude my presentation with one recommendation that I have to the FMD working group. I mentioned also yesterday during the closed session, and I said I'm tired to listen to myself, but you have seen before that the procedure for accepting a country into a certain stage of the PCP is done through regional roadmap meetings. So the country have to get together. Before the meeting, the country are sent a questionnaire. They have to fill the questionnaire. Then there is a regional advisory group which looks into the questionnaire, looks into the data that the country has presented, and at the end they decide, okay, well, you are claiming to be in stage two. They put the stamp and say, fine, you are in stage two. Now, we would like this process to occur independently from having a regional roadmap meeting, because we don't want, for example, in Afghanistan, that our efforts in a way are hampered because there is no regional roadmap meeting. We are producing a lot of data, a lot of information, so we are coming, and we don't want to find the room empty. Nobody's there. So to whom are we going to show our results? So we would like to have at least the room as full as it is today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Giancarlo. I just have to mention that